Good morning and welcome to Restoration Church Online.
My name is Abby, and I'm a member of Restoration Church.
My name is Lori, and this is my son, Will.
My name is Beth Robertson. This is my daughter, Cassie.
We're the Powell family.
This is Jeff and Jenny Strobeck, and we're members of Restoration Church.
Good morning. My name is Cynthia Lipinski.
My name is Michelle.
My name is Skylar.
My name is Sayla.
And my name is Jacob.
My name is Maylee, and I'm a member of Restoration Church.
My name is Mike Rhodes, and I'm so glad you're worshiping with us today.
I'm so glad you're watching today.
My name is Sarah, and I'm so glad you're watching today.
My name is Jason Vandenberg. This is
Jenny.
And that is
Jersey.
And I'm Jennifer Vandenberg.
We're so happy you're worshiping with us today.
And we're so glad that you're worshiping with us.
We're so grateful to be a part of your lives, even just for a short time.
Good morning. Welcome to Restoration Loudoun. My name is Michelle, and I'll be leading us in a time of worship today. Please don't forget to register your attendance. And at any point during the service, if the Holy Spirit is moving, please like and comment below. We would love to hear what the Holy Spirit is doing in your heart today. Let's pray. Holy Spirit, we acknowledge your presence in our midst. We honor you. We bring you glory today. Won't you fill our hearts, fill our homes with more of you? We thank you that you are so good. You are so kind. You've been so generous. We thank you for the outpouring of love. For those that are dry and weary, won't you come and meet us? May this time of worship fill us with a time of peace and joy and strengthen us today. Most importantly, may this time of worship bless you. May our heart cries and songs rise to you and bless your heart, God, and honor you, God. We pray in Jesus' name, amen.
You're more real than the ground I'm standing on. You're more real than the wind in my lungs. Your thoughts define me. belong to you. Abba, I belong to you. Abba,
Church. My name is Jake McLaughlin, and I'm the pastor, and I just want to say welcome. I'm so glad that you're here. Restoration Church is a church that seeks to be a Christ-centered community that welcomes all people. So no matter where you are today, no matter what time you are watching, we're just so glad to be a part of your life, even for a short time. If this is your first time that you are joining us, I want to especially welcome you. We would love to get to know you. You can just say hi in our Facebook or YouTube streams. You can also just click the registration form. We would love to be in relationship with you, to get to know you, and talk to you about the ways that we are living out our calling of loving God and loving our neighbor. Now, starting this Sunday, this evening, we are going to be starting to share things happening in the life of the church outside of these online worship experiences, and we're doing that through a new series and newsletter that we're calling Restoration Weekly. Now, Restoration Weekly, the idea is to provide you all with spiritual resources, opportunities for community building, and ways to serve your community. And we want to really offer up a deep dive into the life of the church with the things that are happening outside of this online worship experience. You will be able to find the video and all of the newsletter on YouTube and Facebook. You can also, in the comments below, you'll see a link to sign up for our email list. Now, Philippians 2, verse 5, suggests that we should have the same mindset as Jesus in order to live in such a way that we are living according to God's will, in a way that allows us and our lives to be more aligned with who God has called us to be. Now, in the gospel stories, we find that Jesus had certain attitudes and practices that we can learn from and that we can emulate today. So over the next 3 weeks, we are going to be doing this new sermon series that we're calling The Jesus Mindset. And we're going to talk about how Jesus lived and acted in the world, and how if we were to do those things, it can change our lives and it can change the lives of people around us. And this week, we're going to take some time and talk about the ways that Jesus noticed the people and places he encountered. You know, Jesus often paid really close attention to things that we often overlooked. And so in our often distracted lives, it takes a lot of energy to notice, from noticing our daily surroundings to noticing the people around us. And sometimes there are surprises in noticing the things around us. So just take a look at this quick video to see what I'm talking about.
The Door Study. This video shows a participant from a 1998 study by Daniel Simons and Daniel Levin. Watch what happens as the unsuspecting pedestrian provides directions. The young man on the left is one of the experimenters. He has approached the white-haired man and asked for directions. Watch closely as two people carrying a door pass between them, and the first experimenter is replaced by someone else. Like many of the people in this study, the pedestrian was entirely unaware that he was talking to a different person. Approximately 50% of the people approached in this study didn't notice when the person they were talking to was replaced by someone else. This study was among the first to demonstrate that change blindness can occur outside of the laboratory.
Sometimes when we notice things that are out of the ordinary or notice things happening with people, it can be a game changer for us. It can be a game changer for the people we come in contact. And if we notice people the way Jesus noticed them, it can also help us find our own compassion and peace. And it can help us see the value in others. And so let's take a look at our scripture today. It comes from the Gospels. We have one of our church members reading it. It's from the Gospel of Matthew, chapter 9, verses 18 to 26.
Today's scripture reading is from the book of Matthew, chapter 9, verses 18 to 26. While he was saying this, a synagogue leader came and knelt before him and said, "My daughter has just died, but come and put your hand on her, and she will live. Jesus got up and went with him, and so did his disciples. Just then a woman who had been subject to bleeding for 12 years came up behind him and touched him on his cloak. She said to herself, "If I only touch his cloak, I will be healed." Jesus turned and saw her. "Take heart, daughter," he said. "Your faith has healed you." And the woman was healed at that moment. When Jesus entered the synagogue leader's house and saw the noisy crowd and people playing pipes, he said, "Go away. The girl is not dead, but asleep." But they laughed at him. After the crowd had been put outside, he went in and took the girl by the hand, and she got up. News of this spread through all of the region.
Now, having heard what our topic is going to be today, and having heard our gospel story from the Gospel of Matthew, I want to take a moment and pray. I want us to pray together that the Holy Spirit might move in our lives in such a way that we might hear the things that we need to hear today. So let's go to God in prayer. Loving and gracious God, thank you so much for this day and this opportunity to be in your midst, albeit virtually. Lord, I know that your Spirit moves. Your Spirit moves in our lives. It moves through our lives. And I would just pray that your grace and your mercy and your peace might be experienced by all those who are watching this message. You are loving, you are powerful, you are an amazing God. And for that, we give you thanks. And we pray this all in your Son's gracious and holy name. Amen. So let me tell you a little story that happened back in 1956. There was this guy, and his name was Wilson Greatbatch. And Wilson was creating a heart rhythm recording device. And so he's tinkering with this device. He's trying to figure out how to put it together. And he reaches into a box for a resistor to complete the circuitry of the stimulator, this recording device that he was creating. But he pulled out the wrong one. It was a little bit too big. And he installed this resistor, even though it was ill-fitting. He did it anyway, and he noticed that the circuit was emitting electrical pulses. And it was pulses that reminded him of the heartbeat. So Greatbatch had previously thought that electrical stimulation might actually be able to stimulate the circuitry of the heart when there was some sort of breakdown. And so this new idea, this thing he happened upon, gave him the idea that it might be possible to create a version of what he made that was small enough that could actually provide this stimulation to the heart. And so he began the work of shrinking the device. And 2 years later, a version of his pacemaker was successfully inserted into a dog. And today, millions upon millions of people have had a better quality of life because he took a chance and noticed something very strange. And recently, in January of this year, a 24-year-old California resident by the name of Alex posted a TikTok video to his 500,000 followers for them to see. It was a parody video. It was a parody video about what it means to be in a relationship, what it means to be married, and part of the video included him showing his bare back. Now, a few of his followers noticed that he had a strange mole growing on his back and encouraged him to get it checked out. They said, "Hey, listen, I don't know if you noticed this, but you have this strange mole, this strange growth on your back that could be cancerous. You should probably go and see a dermatologist." And so about a week later, Alex went to a dermatologist. The dermatologist said, "Yes, we need to take this out." And once they biopsied it, they realized that it was the beginning stages of melanoma. And that happened all because a few of his followers noticed something different when they were watching the video. You know, these two stories exhibit the goodness and the good things that can happen when we notice the things around us, when we notice the people around us. and what people might notice about us as well, what may seem like small things can end up having greater and better outcomes. You know, when we notice that someone's appearance has changed, it can often make them feel like they matter. When we notice an improvement by our kids or by someone at work, it can help them make more progress. There is a power in noticing the people and places around us. You know, throughout the gospel stories, we find instances where people are intentionally seeking out Jesus for help and healing. And our scripture today describes a rabbi asking Jesus to come and heal his dead daughter. And as Jesus is summoned to this little girl, a woman does something really quite audacious. We read from verse 20, it says, "Just then a woman who had been subject to bleeding for 12 years came up behind him and touched the edge of his cloak. She said to herself, 'If only I touch his cloak, I will be healed.' And Jesus turned and saw her. 'Take heart, daughter,' he said, 'your faith has healed you.' And the woman was healed at that moment." And now in the Gospel of Matthew, there are actually very few details about the woman other than the ailment that she lived with and her willingness to reach towards Jesus to get the healing that she needed. Now, interestingly enough, in the Gospel of Luke, the same story is there, but it says that when she touched his cloak, Jesus actually felt the power leave him. And now imagine for just a moment what it may have been like for this woman. The pain that she had suffered for 12 years, the frustration of seeking cure after cure, the desperation in finding and seeking out healing, all of this culminates into her seeking out Jesus. She would do anything to be pain-free, so she takes a chance. And ever so slightly, she touches Jesus' cloak with the hope of healing. And from being shepherded from place to place in the midst of the crowds filled with dust, the blazing sun, the smell of livestock and unwashed bodies, the pleas for help and healing and miracles, Jesus notices this ever so slight touch. Jesus notices her and her faith. He tells her to take heart that her faith is what healed her, all because she took a chance and Jesus noticed her. And so Jesus teaches us that sometimes the things that happen from point A to B, the things that happen in between us wanting to do a task and getting a checkbox, in that space in between are often opportunities that we should pay attention to. You know, to notice, to thoughtfully pay attention in today's world can be a challenge, no doubt about it. There are many appealing distractions in our world. Funny videos on social media, our phones that reward us with notification after notification. There are great shows on Netflix, just to name a few of these wonderful and appealing distractions that we have. And frankly, distractions in many ways can be good. They can help us unwind, like finding a task that when we're feeling overwhelmed or anxious, or watching a great show that makes us laugh. But distractions can also create negative consequences when they cause us to not be able to turn in our homework, or when we forget someone's birthday because we're so distracted, or when we miss a deadline at work. You know, if we are to glean anything from this woman and how Jesus interacts with her, there is healing, depth, and discovery in noticing people and things that are around us. It's noticing the trivial sigh of a loved one. It's finding joy and peace in the small things that we do or that we see. When we notice more intently, we find glimpses into greater understanding. We find peace. We find the possibility of deeper relationships. We may even have an experience of wonder or joy. You know, Jesus shows that we should pay close attention to the space between point A and point B, the space between writing down the task and checking the box, the space between the problem and the solution. And noticing that often neglected space in between can lead to deep change. It can lead to peace. It can lead to a new orientation. And frankly, friends, I think in order for us to understand the power of noticing, all we have to really do is take some reflection in our own lives and remember those times when we were noticed ourselves. I mean, maybe you can remember a time when you were in middle school and you were at the middle school dance and you were waiting for that person that you had a crush on to take a look at you, to ask you to dance, and the lights change. A slow song comes on, and you meet eyes, and you dance. And it's like you're dancing on clouds. It's just so very wonderful. Or maybe you remember the first time you held your child in your arms, and your eyes locked together, and you realized in that moment, fully focused on that child, that you were now a parent. Or maybe you can remember a time where you were really struggling with a problem. The grief over a loved one, a relationship issue, a health diagnosis that brought some bad news to your life, and a loved one or a friend notices it without you saying a word and sits down next to you, grabs your hand, and it's just present with you because they know that their presence brings a healing touch. There is power in the things that we notice. You know, it can be life-changing. It can be orientation-shifting when we notice others and when we are noticed. But let's also remember this basic understanding of our faith here and now, and that is that Jesus notices you. Jesus celebrates in your victories. Jesus holds your hand and walks alongside you when you struggle, when you receive bad news, when things get hard. Jesus sent his people, the Holy Spirit, to guide us so that we may live in the most full way possible. You know, in the crowded space of our hearts, Jesus rejoices with us. Jesus walks alongside us. And friends, because of that, maybe moving forward, we can be a people that notice others. Maybe we can be a people that bring peace to the world by how we pay attention, because there's joy and wonder in noticing. And here are some ways that we can do that. The first thing that we can do is continue the conversation. Next week, our topic for the Jesus Mindset is talking about listening. So I'm not going to spend a lot of time talking about listening right now, other than saying many of us would benefit from listening more and talking less. I would benefit from that. And I would imagine for some of you listening and watching today, you could probably say the same thing. And so I wonder, in this week to come, when you are having conversations, can you try to find ways to extend the conversation, to offer people an opportunity to share more than they thought they might be willing or able to share? Let me just give you a quick way to do that. Three words. Tell me more. So imagine you're talking to a loved one or to a friend, and you say, "Hey, how's it going? Hey, how are you doing?" And they say, "I'm okay. Tell me more," is a way to prompt them to know that you are there, that you are paying attention, that you noticed that there's something going on that you want to share. There is power in noticing. So take some time this week to find ways to continue the conversation. The next thing that we can do is we can put down our devices. Now, I understand that you're probably watching this on a device, so don't turn it off yet. Just hear me out. Listen, most of us need our phones for work. Most of us watch movies and do banking and have conversations with people across the country. Our phones are really important, and frankly, there's nothing you can't do with a phone, but the truth is our phones can be really distracting. A long walk or a jog can be disrupted by a phone call or a text message. A deep conversation with a loved one can be derailed by the sound of a notification. It's a really hard challenge for us to find peace and quiet if all we do is pull out our phone, check and see what's next, check and see what's next. That pretty much gets rid of the possibility of finding peace and quiet when sometimes we need to be present. So take some time each day, just a little bit of time each day, put your phone somewhere where you don't see it and you don't want to grab it, and just be present in the moment. Maybe when you're having that conversation, maybe when you're eating dinner with your family, maybe when you are taking a walk, just take some time and put down your device. And then finally, I would strongly encourage you all to remember the things that you notice. I hope that the Spirit moves you to pay more attention to things that truly matter in your lives. And maybe one of the things that we can do is pay attention so much that we can maybe write down those things that we notice that are different. Maybe we can take a picture of something we see that brings about a sense of awe or joy in our lives. Any reflection that we can do offers us an opportunity to get a deeper glimpse into our lives, maybe a glimpse into a deeper relationship or into the beauty and wonder of the world that we live in. You know, like I said before, friends, Jesus noticed this woman's glancing touch on his cloak as he was being shepherded from point A to point B. He noticed this ever slight touch. And you know what? It made all the difference for this woman. It literally changed her life. It brought her the healing she needed. And so just as Jesus notices you, just as the Holy Spirit longs to prompt you into a way of living that brings about grace and healing and peace in the world, let us take the time to notice the people around us, to notice the places, and to notice how God is working in and through us. Thanks be to God. Amen.
My Jesus, I love thee. I know thou art mine. For thee all the follies of sin I resign. My gracious Redeemer, my Savior art thou. If ever I love thee, my Jesus, 'tis now. The thorn. thou lendest me breath, and say when the death dew lies cold on my brow, if ever I love thee, my Jesus, 'tis now.
Friends, I am just so happy that you worshiped alongside us today. Did you hear something that was meaningful or helpful for you today? I wonder if you will just take a moment and like, share, or comment on this stream. You know, anytime we get one more subscriber on YouTube, anytime we get one more share on Facebook, it has the possibility of reaching someone who needs to hear the words of God. For someone who needs to hear the gospel stories, for someone who needs community. So take the time, like, share, or comment at your earliest convenience. You know, I hope that you'll also take time to notice people and places around you, the words and tones of your loved ones, the beauty of nature, the beauty of our world. I hope you pay attention to the movement of the Holy Spirit in your life, because God is trying to show you something. I hope you have a great week. Go in peace, and go now in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. May the grace and peace of Christ be with you. Amen.